Hey everyone, my name is Matt Vardi and I'm a technical support engineer at Cockroach Labs. And today I'm going to be doing a brief demo on using a load balancer in front of CockroachDB. The reason why we want to use a load balancer is to improve the performance and resiliency of our cluster. Simply put, it allows us to utilize all of the nodes in our cluster instead of just one. And the reason we can do that is because in CockroachDB, every node is a gateway node. So we can send our SQL to any of the nodes and the cluster will process that SQL and return it to the client. Getting set up with a load balancer in CockroachDB is really simple. All we need is one of the IP addresses of one node in the cluster, and we're going to run this command right here, which is built into the Cockroach binary. And this is what that file looks like. And we can see it's got the three IP addresses of our cluster. And once we've set up our load balancer file, we just have to run this command to start the load balancer. And today I'm going to be showing you two examples, one of which we connect to only one node in the cluster and send all of our connections to that one node, and the other where we're going to utilize the load balancer. And so what I'm going to show right now is the first scenario. And so we can see that I'm sending all of my connections over here to node 3, which is the red node. It's pretty obvious that we're not utilizing node 1 and node 2 in this scenario. And I'm going to show you in the hardware dashboard how much overhead that node has. So we can see that the overhead is pretty unfair. And so node 3 is doing all of the processing while node 1 and node 2 aren't doing that much work. And so the whole point of the load balancer is that we can spread our requests evenly throughout the whole cluster. So we've been running the first test without sending the request to the load balancer for a couple of minutes now, and we can see that we're getting about 1,000 queries per second, and that's pretty consistent over the last couple of minutes. We can still see that node 3 is processing all of the requests while node 1 and node 2 aren't doing that much work. So switching over to our second scenario where we're sending all of our connections to the load balancer, we can see that the requests are evenly spread out between the three nodes as opposed to just one node. And the hardware utilization should be much more uniform across the nodes in the cluster. And so what we're seeing here is that each node is utilizing its resources, and we're getting about 1,500 queries per second over here on the right-hand side. And what that means is that because we're utilizing the load balancer, we're getting about 50% more throughput than we were before. Just to recap, we saw three things today. We saw how easy it was to get set up in CockroachDB with the load balancer. We saw a 50% increase in throughput, which means in that same 1 second, our database is going to be processing 50% more requests than it was before. And that's a really positive improvement on our application. And we also saw an improvement in resiliency. By sending all of our connections to the load balancer, we won't have a single point failure with just one node. It's super easy to get set up, and you can get started at cockroachlabs.com.